ride or die. Cause I'm low on the phone, you see. So I talk till I drop, you see. How could I have a heart made of stone? Why you? Oh, and we synchronize. It's exactly what I feel when I fantasize. Playing games with my mind, making us collide. And we know how it goes when we're out at night. And I don't know how we make it out when we make out on the low. Even if it rains, you'd rather make it snow. Both you and me know we gotta let it go. Laying on the ground, wondering why it's so cold. How we make it out when we make out on the low. Even if it rains, you'd rather make it snow. Both you and me know we gotta let it go. Laying on the ground, wondering why it's so cold. When you bet your nice, you're so satisfied. When I dig in the dirt, you're in paradise. And I know that you know I can sleep at night. Oh, and you're by my side. And it's smooth how you move, cause I'm petrified. Setting traps in my head, messing with my mind. When you talk, but I know you're lying. And I don't know. If I was to call your phone, I know you'd click. Baby, can I have the throne? I call it quits. You can even have my car, I don't need it. I've been inside my room since you left it. Thinking about the place where we first kissed. Oh, and I don't know how we make it out when we make out on the low. Even if it rains, you'd rather make it snow.
Face you'll be seeing in-game in the new season is Vernon Carey Jr. Coming from Duke, he's now wearing a Hornets jersey, and as it turns out, he's a big fan of 2K, and he's pretty good on the sticks. We caught up with him after his first week of training. Take a look. Congratulations on being drafted to the Hornets, and welcome to
forward at 6'6", Number 20, Gordon Hayward. At the point, standing 5'11", number 8, Kemba Walker. Starting at the other guard, at 6'6", number 7, Jaylen Brown. The other forward, standing 6'8", number 0, Jayson Tatum. Your head coach is Brad Stevens. Let's hear it for your Boston Celtics.
Welcome, everyone, to a brand new season of NBA basketball. I'm sure you're as excited as all of us are here at 2K Sports as we get ready to start the season in style. This is Kevin Harlan, and beside me, Greg Anthony and Steve Smith. David Aldridge joins us on the sidelines. D.A., take it away.
Hey, Kevin, thank you very much. What a great comeback story for Derrick Rose. His resilience over the years of injuries has been rewarded. He says everybody struggles. People pretend like they don't. My down days were on TV, so I couldn't hide. The whirlwind I was in, I always stayed calm. I think that's just part of who I am. It's my character. Kevin?
Good insight there, Dave. Thank you. A moment now to see how the schedule is looking for Detroit. On Wednesday, they'll take on Karl Anthony Towns and the Minnesota Timberwolves. Then on Saturday, they'll take on Kevin Love and the Cleveland Cavaliers. And now the opening lineup for Detroit. They've got Griffin. Tony Snell is out there with Hayes. Then it's Christian Wood. And it's Bay in at the three. And for the Celtics, Walker and Brown, they're manning the backcourt. Hayward at small forward with Tatum at the four. And it's Tice in at the five. And for teams already exceeding expectations, Greg, their spirits are running sky high right now.
Kev, it's always a great feeling to come out strong. But it is hard to maintain that consistency.
Yeah,
the
agreed.
Teams that do, you know, they believe in themselves and they keep playing to their strengths.
Why is consistency so hard?
You know, because you're not playing against yourself. And we're human. And, Kevin, as great as you are as a broadcaster, you probably have had some days where you haven't felt, didn't feel as good as you did other days. And that's no different for a guy competing at this level.
My friend, that's every day. Every day you don't feel good about it. But you grind, right? You just try
that's
to keep
right.
grinding.
Got to do it.
Here's Hayes. Kemba Walker making his last shot. Pass to Griffin. Down low. Wood kicks to Griffin. It's stolen by Tice. Here's Tatum. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
And how about Tatum there using his muscle, easily absorbing the contact and still able to knock down the shot.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
In their last contest, guys, he was unconscious from the foul line.
One shot.
For Boston, they come into this one following a loss to the Brooklyn Nets. Now Hayes. Passes to Snell. The Pistons working the ball around now. And that one's good. Griffin.
This is where Blake does most of his damage. Just get him the rock inside the paint.
Walker goes in. Banked in off the glass. Walker's got his second basket.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Wow, that's a defensive breakdown. Can't do that against good scores.
Pass to Griffin. Back to Hayes. The three. He doesn't hit that one. And it's Boston the other way. Here's Tatum. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Tatum's got his second bucket of the night.
A lot of enthusiasm to the start of this game. So far, a perfect 4-for-4.
And Jayson Tatum, he got a lot of the pub last year, and deservedly so. But Jaylen Brown made monstrous strides as well, especially when it came to efficiency.
We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Now here's Hayes, guarded by Walker. Tatum against Griffin. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2-for-2. And you look at Brown's field goal percentage and his free throw percentage, Greg, both career highs last season.
And Kev, his shot was never broken. The motion never had to be rebuilt. Brown's problem coming into the league was that he would shoot the ball differently every time. Once he landed on the repeatable mechanics, you could see the consistency start to take form.
Here's Griffin following the basket by Jaylen Brown. Great open look there.
They have really found a rhythm here early. 4-for-5 to start this game.
Walker with it. Hayes on him. Walker's shot is off.
He goes up strong, but he is met with resistance. I think that surprised him a little bit.
And the pass to Hayes. And another three for Detroit.
That's a shot the defense looked like it was willing to give up. Big mistake.
Brown drives in, and then Brown with the dunk.
And really, Brown is astonishing when he takes it inside. The defense does not know what to do with him.
Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Snell, that's good.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Brown drives in. Bucket number three. He's a perfect 3-for-3 to start.
And guys, I don't think Brown gets enough credit for his toughness. This is a guy who never shies away from contact.
Now here's Hayes. He's got 5. And there's the foul. It's on Jaylen Brown. That's his first foul. Three-pointer, Snell. It's rebounded by Tice. The Celtics have gone 7-of-8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting. Count the basket. Brown's got 8.
In case anyone was wondering, this is what it looks like when you're in the zone. He hasn't missed one all quarter.
Outside Griffin. Knocked away. And stolen by Tatum. And Griffin sends it back.
I love the defensive intensity from Blake Griffin on that play.
Snell, the pass to Griffin. Detroit, no good that time either.
Missed opportunity, wide open from mid-range. He would love to get that one back.
And he comes up with the deuce. Tatum's got his third basket of the night. Pistons trail by 4. Now here's Hayes. Pass to Wood. Oh, Griffin in position. Hammers the alley-oop through.
Blake Griffin was pointing his finger to throw it up way high, and he went, got it, and dunked it home.
And it's Brown that time on the assist by Walker. 10 points for him.
And that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, nowhere to be found.
Now here's Hayes, guarded closely, stolen by Walker. Here's Tatum. No good on that one. Griffin with some nice D. He kicks to Hayes. Hits the three-point bomb. Hayes has got a couple of threes now in the first for the Pistons.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc. Just no resistance on the inside. That's their 5th consecutive make in the paint.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. Marcus Smart checked in for the Celtics. And then for Detroit, Mekhi Lucas checked in. And Derrick Rose is subbed in for Tony Snell.
What's up?
And the vertical that Brown has is pretty impressive, as relentless a finisher as you'll find in our league.
And taken away by Brown. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. And the three ball is good.
Timeout.
Brown's got 16 points.
Throughout the evening, he's gotten to his spots, and the defense has not adjusted.
And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. Greg, with your son getting drafted, you joined the ranks of some historic NBA father-son duo.
You know, I got the opportunity to play with Arvydas Sabonis in Portland, and remember DeMontis as a little kid.
No kidding.
He's an all-star last year. You know, I think you're going to have an influx of that in the coming years. Dwayne Wade's son is a terrific player. We know about LeBron's son's ability. He's possibly heading to the league one day. You just never know. I'm as a dad, it's going to get the opportunity to watch his son and play excited, but I think you're going to see more of this in the future.
Cole and Greg Anthony, I like the way that sounds.
Now at the numbers for Jaylen Brown. He had a strong showing last season. He put up about 20 points per game last season, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists. But to have a scorer like him consistently deliver you points makes such a big difference for a team.
Because he gives you someone to build your offense around, you can count on his nightly production.
Now here's Rose. 14 points from him the last game against Washington.
It was never all about himself. He came away with a lot of assists in that game and just kind of kept everybody in the mix. Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
A shot by Griffin. Nobody around. And no good. The dry spell continuing for him. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession. Austin making some changes. Cantor's checked in for Daniel Tice. Williams comes in for Jayson Tatum. And Brad Wanamaker subbed in for Kemba Walker. Thon Maker's checked in for Detroit. Musa comes in for Hayes. And so Griffin will bring it up for the Pistons. They trail by 9 points. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
He's hot this quarter, getting the shots he wants, and he's delivering.
And when he first came into the league, Blake Griffin's dunking made headlines. And while I'm sure he enjoyed that, he was also eager to show that there was more to his game.
And you know, Greg, in the past, Griffin felt at times criticized as being a one-dimensional player.
I tell you, Kevin, I think he's answered those critics. If you look at his passing and his development as a shooter, one of the more complete offensive players in the league. Not the kind of aggressive defense they need to cut into the lead.
Yeah, you have to protect the rim, Greg, a little better.
Also, if you can't get stops at this point, it really doesn't matter what you do at the offensive end.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
And here's Rose. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. 13 feet away.
And they've done a nice job controlling the defensive backboard to start this game.
Here's Maker. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
This is what you get from Maker. A legit 7-footer who brings the energy.
Wanamaker misses.
Out of character for him to miss that shot. Maybe just a little too casual there.
Here's Rose. It's hauled in by Brown.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
He just cannot miss. Eight up, eight in. Flawless.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
2 points. That one goes.
Tremendous vision D-Rose has. Always finding ways to make an impact.
Nice shot by Smart.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Passes it to Griffin. Fires from deep. Mikhailiuk can't get it to go. Celtics leading by eight. Here's Brown, and Brown throws it down hard.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
I'll tell you, this was their strategy coming in. They obviously identified a weakness there inside.
Here's Mikhailiuk. Usa passes to Griffin. And the call will be against Thon Maker. That's his first foul. Dumboy is checked in for Detroit. So it's the Celtics now. 10-point lead. Here's Wanamaker, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Rose passes to Dumboya. Nice ball movement by Detroit. And it's denied. Left side, Brown.
Building up a big early lead, they have taken charge of this game.
Play calling has been fantastic. They've been a step ahead of the defense since the opening tip.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
Here's Smart. Here's Cantor. Detroit with the rebound. Shot to stop the run, and it's blocked by Brown. Smart finds Cantor over Maker, and good as it just snugs right down through the net.
And this is where Smart has really improved. The game's slowed down for him. He's playing under better control. Nice pass.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. You and I have talked about how the NBA Finals used to be tape delayed. What's the value of fans getting to see the broadcast live now as opposed to tape delayed as it was back in the 70s?
Isn't that weird to even think that that's the case?
I know it.
You know, I think, Kev, that the fans, they just feel more connected to their favorite teams, the end players. It creates more anxiety, right? Because nowadays there's nothing that can happen that you don't know about it, whether you see it or not. So live sports, especially the NBA Finals, the anticipation, that anxiety that we talked about, man, I'm still a fan to this day in a different way. So I can only imagine when you have a personal vested interest in a team, what that's got to feel like.
Edge of your seat, you're right. Robert Williams is checked in for Williams. McCray's checked in for the Pistons. Pistons trail by 16. And taken away by Brown. There's 1:54 left here in the first quarter.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And so it's Rose bringing it up for the Detroit Pistons. Poke loose. And now in transition, here's Williams. Here we go. Wasted no time on that one. And the Celtics lead by 20.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
This has been an impressive performance tonight. Even with a big lead, they've maintained their focus. Defensively, a breakdown along the perimeter. Just too slow to rotate.
Here's Cantor. That's good, and he's now 3-for-4 from the field.
And on the glass so far, it hadn't even been close.
Pistons trailed by 19. Rose surveying the D. to the paint. Here's Maker and the dunk by Maker.
You can fall in love with floating around the perimeter. I like it when Maker attacks the rim.
Here's Wanamaker. Good. The nice assist for Williams.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
The Pistons shooting it very well as they shake off the rust here early. 54% from the field. High arcing shot. Rose, that's good.
Derrick Rose, against the defense, surprised him a little bit with that floating jump shot.
Here's Wanamaker, who's covered by Rose. 6 second difference between the shot and game clock. McRae passes to Maker for the three. Rose, no good.
I mean, he's staying aggressive, trying to regain his touch, but right now, he's hurting the team.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create.
You know, if you get the ball to the right guy in the right spot, more often than not, you're coming away with points. Terrific play. This is why you run your offense through him and live with the results.
Jaylen Brown has been leading the charge for the Boston Celtics. They kept going to him again and again, and he delivered with a monster quarter. Back to the action after this word. And before the game, we checked in with Marcus Smart, who told us how his upbringing helped shape his approach to the game.
I'm the youngest of four boys. So as anybody who has siblings, older, younger, you understand the struggle, especially being the youngest. You know, you always got to fight for what you want.
And no question, Smart is considered one of the toughest guys, Greg, in the NBA.
You have to love his passion, his willingness to sacrifice his body for the team on a nightly basis.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And for the Celtics here, they've been putting on a show, guys.
Hey, why take jump shots when you can get your points at the rim?
Especially at the start. You want to get something positive going and establish your rhythm.
On the floor for Detroit, Rose is out there with McRae. Then there's Maker. Then there's Dumboya. And it's Bay in at the small forward. Rose, good.
This is why Derrick Rose is considered one of the best at his position. He is not afraid of going down low.
Count that bucket.
And watching that defensive effort right there, you wonder how much they want this game.
They are getting bare tonight with plays like that one, allowing too much space for a good shooter.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, if you can believe it, before Jaylen Brown went to the draft, one executive said the Cal Berkeley star was too smart. Brown says, when athletes are also informative, it can intimidate. We get pushback for our outside interests. The whole shut up and dribble movement is big, and I'm a part of that movement. Guys?
Strong story, DA, there, thanks. Here's Rose, following the bucket by the Celtics. And Detroit again with the bucket.
Man, he keeps doing his part. They just haven't been able to get over the hump.
All sorts of time. Again, the Pistons score.
Just another day at the office. D. Rose knows when and where to get his points.
Here's Williams. Makes it off the glass. Williams has got his second basket of the night.
Man, just adding insult to injury. He just waltzes inside and extends this lead.
A uncontested shot at the rim. You have to compete at all times.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys. And as he gets older, we've seen Derrick Rose coming out of his shell a bit more. Early in his career, he was wary of strangers and the media.
So it's Detroit now, following the bucket by the Celtics. It's Smart with the drive. Yep, that one goes in there. Smart's got six.
And this is why you gave Hayward big money, not just a score in this offense.
And growing up, Derrick Rose protected by his family from the dangers of Chicago. Then, Greg, after starring at the University of Memphis, he was drafted by his hometown Bulls.
Anointed a savior from day one. And you talk about a life under the microscope. Sports writers picking him apart, rabid fans wanting a piece. In a lot of ways, it's probably better for him not playing in Chicago. And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question, toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
Some changes here for the Celtics. Daniel Tice is checked in for Enes Kanter. Tatum comes in for Robert Williams. And Walker subbed in for Brad Wanamaker. And a different look here for the Pistons. Wood, he's checked in for Thon Maker. Griffin comes in for Doumbouya. Tony Snell's checked in for McCray. And Hayes subbed in for Derrick Rose.
I mean, hard to fathom that Blake Griffin is becoming one of the more prolific three-point shooters among NBA big men.
Greg, it was a shot he barely attempted through his first six seasons in the league. Now he's made it a key part of his arsenal.
And the first one drops. Greg, did you know when you were playing that you'd eventually want to call games, be in the broadcast table?
Kevin, no idea. I didn't have any clue. And quite honestly, didn't really think that there was a career that one could have in terms of broadcasting. You know, because cable was just kind of coming on as I was retiring. You didn't have your own network and the things that we take for granted now. So looking back on it, no, but boy, am I glad I did.
I am glad you did, too. You probably don't remember this. Doc Rivers and I were doing a game. You came over to say hi to the two of us, went back out on the floor. Doc nudges me and said he'll be great in TV someday. We saw it then.
He's a good mind. The man knows what he's talking about.
Griffin against Tatum. Now the fast break. Tatum with the ball. He misses it. He's 4-for-7 from the floor. Pistons trail by 15. Here's Wood. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And Christian Wood, undrafted in 2015 out of UNLV. Wait a minute, that's your alma mater. Hey, talk about his game. What do you like about Christian Wood's game?
Well, first I'll start with he went to UNLV. He's long, he's lean. I think he really fits the modern NBA as a small ball center, able to hold his own on the glass and space the floor.
He's off on the first. He hits the second from the line.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Celtics leading by 14. And it's Walker penetrating. He gets it in there. Walker's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And a capable score from anywhere on the floor. You give Walker those kinds of looks, and he's going to make you pay.
Now here's Hayes. 8 points for him. Wood kicks to Hayes. They get the rebound. Pass to Snell. Lets it go with a three. Comes up empty here. That puts him at 3-for-6.
Well, he was in rhythm, hitting two threes in the opening quarter, but hasn't made one since.
Shots good by Walker.
poor interior defense. If you play him soft, he's going to kill you.
Here's Hayes. Here's Wood. Nice work on the board. It's paying off with the basket.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Here's Smart. The putback kept alive by Boston. They shoot again. Wood with the block. And they're able to recover. Pistons trail by 16. Right wing from the arc. Drains it from beyond the arc. Wood's got his second bucket tonight.
He's an asset in helping space the floor. He has tremendous touch from range.
Nice shot by Smart.
A tremendous find there by Kemba. He draws loads of attention, opens the court up for his teammates.
Snell dishes to Hayes. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Tipped away and stolen by Tatum. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Here's Walker. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
And Walker, the definition of a creative finisher. No foul, no problem.
And there's the pass to Griffin. Launches it. Hayes, no good.
He's kind of lost his way this period, having a hard time getting anything to go down.
Tice trying to break free, and he gets it back. Nice shot by Smart.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Pass to Bay to the left side wing. And he lobs it up toward the rim. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
You know, Blake Griffin, he gives you a little bit of everything offensively. Terrific court awareness.
So the Celtics call timeout, their first. And not only is Smart one of the best defenders in the league, Greg, he's also one of the most versatile players in the NBA.
Yeah, when you talk about players who can guard 1 through 5, it's usually referring to Kawhi, PG-13, or Giannis. But Smart at 6'4 has the strength, the anticipation, and the toughness to hold his own against anyone. It's remarkable.
Some changes here for the Celtics. Williams comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Jaylen Brown subbed in for Smart. And a switcher also for Detroit. Makai Lucas checked in. Tice trying to break free. Shots good by Walker. Walker's got 14 points.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Passes it to Snell. Here's Makai Luke. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Mikhailuk's got his second bucket.
Passes like this demonstrate Snell's team-first approach. He's all about getting it to the open guys.
Some solid defense from Brown.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead. Oh, that's straight TNT, baby. Explosive.
That was pretty, and he just has that effortless knack for getting inside. Pistons trail by 18. Pass to Wood. And it's blocked. It's Brown on the wing. Covered by Hayes. Brown, good.
And that's where Brown is at his best. A muscular beast who loves finishing strong through the contact.
Now here's Hayes. Guarded by Walker. Griffin looking it over. Five to shoot. Williams with the block. Wood kicks to Hayes. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. 10 points for him. And Walker's got the ball here for the Celtics. Here's Williams, and Griffin sends it back. Good work there as it goes.
And Kevin, they dialed up their activity this quarter. We're seeing them convert a lot of those second chance opportunities.
Hayes with it. 10 points for him. Now Griffin. Great D that time from Tatum. And the dunk by Tatum.
A terrific athlete at that wing with good bounce. Tatum, fun to watch.
Detroit's gone 7-15 from three-point range tonight. They're not afraid of that shot. There's the pass to Wood. To the middle. Here's Mikhailiuk. And he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
Relentless on the offensive glass, and then you love the finish.
Here's Tatum, and slam dunk by Tatum.
Offensively, just versatile. Tatum keeps his defenders on edge with so many moves with the ball.
Detroit's gone 2-for-5 from three-point land since the end of the first. And stolen by Tatum. Walker, and the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
On a team filled with big wings last year, Walker gave the Celtics a guy with great supreme quickness who could break down the defense when nothing else was there.
And he's that rare commodity, an elite catalyst who doesn't have to dominate the ball to make an impact. That allows room for others to feel empowered out on the floor. It's just one of the many ways Walker makes his teammates better.
That's good from Kemba Walker.
And you always know what you're going to get from Walker from the line. He's been a solid, consistent free throw shooter his entire career.
Griffin can't get it to go in.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Defensively, they've had no answer for him this period, and he continues to stay aggressive.
And for the Pistons, they're shooting in the second quarter, right around 48%. Musa passes to Rose. Can they get it? No good. Now Boston takes it the other way. Here's Tatum. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Tatum's got 8 points here in this quarter.
I'm sorry. That's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Here's Walker. Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
Getting the and one. Kemba shows off the deft touch he has on the ball. You have to finesse around that hard of defense, and he does it as well as anybody.
The Celtics have made 3 free throws so far. Haven't missed any. Boston making a switch here. Cantor's checked in.
One shot.
That's good from Walker. Here's McCray. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Rose. The feed now to Dumboya. Up and in. Off to an efficient start. 2-for-3 from the field.
And Kevin, they started the game shooting it so well. I'm surprised they haven't continued. They've got to get back to their strength. And if you look at this first half, overall, they've just had the better shot selection.
What they have done is ran their plays all the way through until they get something they like.
Here's McCray following the bucket by the Celtics. Here's Rose. And he can't bank that one in.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area.
Detroit's gone outside a lot tonight, 17 times, in fact, 7 of 17. Doomboya can't get it to go. The Celtics shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively.
And you gotta love how seriously Brown takes his ability to score. He has the green light to fire from just about anywhere on the court.
58 seconds left in the first half. Here's McRae. Shot number 12 goes in. He's made 7 of 12 now.
They're still behind, but not because of his efforts. He's been unbelievable this quarter.
Here's Brown. That shot, no good. And, well, Detroit shooting 51% from the field. They'll take that. Pass to McRae. Launches a 3. Bangs home the trifecta. McRae has got his first 3 points of the game.
Derrick Rose moving the basketball with ease, really setting up his teammates, setting the plate for them.
Shot's good by Walker.
His shot making has been superb this quarter. He's taken over this game.
And turnovers have been the issue for him.
You can see the coaches have gotten into him a little bit about this. They've got to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
Love the aggressiveness, the tenacity of Derrick Rose. Love driving the basketball into the teeth of the defense.
And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a 3-point play. Going to the line for 3-1. This trip is his second to the free throw line in this one.
At the line for the Celtics, Jaylen Brown. At the line with one shot.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
That free throw good from Brown. There's 18 seconds left in the first half of the game. Walker against Rose, and that one drops. Rose has got 18 points in the game.
It's hard to try to stop D. Rose. When he's committed to scoring, get out of his way.
And Wanamaker gets it to go.
Pushing the action, getting others involved. He does it time and time again.
You know what it is? It's his creativity. That's making this engine run.
And so it's the Boston Celtics out there all by themselves with a 32-point lead to end the quarter. And they're winning the turnover battle very easily in this one. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Coach, you're in a good position here at the break. What do you tell your team to make sure they don't let up?
Well, I don't think it's about letting up or playing better. It's just playing the right way. We just have to play good basketball. And we talked about it before the game. That's our goal going into the game. That doesn't change no matter what the score is. So that'll be the discussion at halftime.
Thanks very much, Coach. Back to you.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And what a show being put on here for the home fans tonight. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. A tremendous game we're seeing from Jaylen Brown. He ended up with 33 points, 4 rebounds, and 1 block. He's really stood out for them to this point. Kenny, what's your take on Boston so far?
It's almost impossible to be hotter than they were in the first half. They made just about everything they looked at. Even when they were taking bad shots, they were hitting them. They probably can't stay that hot all game, but hey, they might.
And Shaq, what are your thoughts on Detroit?
Well, there's no two ways around it. They got trounced on the glass and on the scoreboard. They got to show a little more fight down low. Looks like they're not competing, and it's showing on the boards most of all.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See everybody with Kevin Harlan.
I'm the son of a saint. And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. It's been a clinic out there by Jaylen Brown.
The burst he's had when going at the rim has been fantastic. A lot of strong finishes through two quarters.
His activity level has made an impact, and he is fearless.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Brown and Hayward, they're the wings. Daniel Tice out there with Enes Kanter, and it's Walker in at the point guard. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. And Kemba Walker is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. We have got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
And that's what a team needs when they're trailing. Energy on D.
Over to the left wing. Bay buries the long-range jumper. Bay's got the opening bucket to start the second half for Detroit. It's Brown with the drive, and Brown throws it down.
And just awesome speed from Brown, blasting off towards the bucket and slamming it down.
The Pistons shooting an outstanding 53% for the game. Now here's Hayes. Not a lot of room. To the inside. The shot's good from Griffin. Griffin's got 13 points.
Terrific play call to give him a clean look at the rim. That's how you want to start the second half.
Listen, put the ball in the hands of your best scorers and let them go to work. Keep it simple.
And this is where Walker thrives, an assertive long-distance shooter.
Here's Hayes. It's deflected. Hayward against Griffin. Here's Tice. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Tice has got his first bucket of the night.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Kanter against Griffin. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Kanter. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. Hayward leading the charge. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Just crushing it here. 80% to start the half.
Pistons have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Pass to Bay to stop the run. And Hayward with the block. Left side, Brown. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the foul against Detroit.
I admire the energy that Brown plays with, so great at getting to the line.
The Celtics shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight.
And as a team, excellent. A season ago, about 80% when they got to the line.
First one falls for him. The Celtics making a switch here. Tatum's checked in. And Brown drops them both. The Pistons shooting has been great, up over 50%. In fact, 52%. Hayes the pass to Snell. And a miss there on the triple.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed. Well, now that they've settled into this game, you can see the offense is firing on all cylinders.
Yeah, the reason why they made the adjustments they needed to make. They are executing.
Now here's Hayes. 10 points for him. And again, it's the Pistons missing.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
You know what? This has always been a debate. Do you take the timeout, or do you let your guys try to fight through it?
For Boston, they have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in 7 attempts. Smart's checked in for the Celtics.
At the line with 1 shot.
Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Inside. Wood kicks to Snell. Drills the three-pointer. Snell's got his third basket of the night right there.
And really, Snell needs no time at all to get his jump shot off. He's looking to score once he gets the pass.
Nice shot by Smart.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
Here's Bay. He's got nine. Here's Hayes. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Tatum drives in, and the dunk by Tatum.
What I like here, even with the big lead, they continue to execute their offense.
They've taken nothing for granted. You can see they're playing the moment rather than the score.
Now here's Hayes. He's got 10. Outside Griffin. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Tice.
All right, a chance to check out stats for Marcus Smart. Some last season stats for him. Averaged about 13 points a game, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds. He's been making the right decisions and letting the game come to him. Solid play all around.
He's not trying to take over necessarily. He's just taking what the defense allows and contributing to the calls.
4 on the clock. Here's Griffin. Hands it from downtown. Griffin's got 5 points in the quarter.
Man, that's sure got to be a load off his mind after not hitting a single three-pointer in that first half. The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's Griffin. 16 points for him. Wood with the bucket.
He has to show real leadership out there and take this game into his own hands because he's shooting the ball well.
And so Wanamaker will bring it up for the Celtics. Here's Smart. In for his 7th make in 14 tries.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Detroit's gotten the 3-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. Here's Snell. 9 points in the game so far. The dish to Griffin. And he banks in the layup. Griffin's got 18 points in the game.
Great job executing the offense. That pass on time and on point.
And out of New Mexico, Tony Snell has made himself into a capable long-range marksman.
Yes, he's a guy who plays within himself, GA, stays in his lane, and knocks down perimeter shots.
Here's Griffin. Marcus Smart picking up that last basket. That shot off. Got that one up quick.
He's in fuego right now. When he gets like this, he's hard to stop.
For Detroit, they've gone at a pretty good shooting pace. They're 6 of 13 from the field here in the third. Hayes the pass to Snell. And another 3 for Detroit.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. 3 of their last 5 baskets are from 3-point range.
Wanamaker misses. Detroit's got more than a 50% success rate on their 3-pointers since halftime. They're 4 of 7. Hayes, no good.
Woo, that's just a case of bad defense and even worse offense.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
And over the course of last year, he was up over 90%. And with a stroke like that, you see why.
The first free throw is good.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Williams, he's checked in for Daniel Tice, and it's Williams in for Gordon Hayward. That one falls, so he hits both of them. We know, Greg, the NBA is full of superstars, yet you can foul out of the game after 6 personal fouls, and some have suggested instead just tacking on an extra free throw when a player commits their 6th plus foul. and then they can stay in the game.
You know, I think something along those lines could make sense. No doubt it's tough to see the marquee player riding the bench because it's not just the sixth foul, right? In some coaches, you pick up two in the first quarter, you're done for the quarter. You pick up a third in the second, you're done for the half.
Yes.
So I would like to see something, but I think it's got to also be fair. Maybe you get free throws and another possession. Maybe something along those lines might be in the best interest of the game.
I like that. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
And Derrick Rose said when he first attempted to come back from his injuries, he was playing revenge basketball. Now he just seems so much more at ease.
Yeah, I agree, GA. I'll tell you, he still has that competitive spirit in him. Yes, check that off. I think now he's just happier to be able to play the basketball injury-free. And to see his teammates and the league respond when he had that 50-point game, people were really generally happy for Derrick Rose.
Thon Makers checked in for Blake Griffin.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good.
A fan favorite in this league. Rose's hard work and perseverance through injuries speaks volumes.
And Rose drops them both. Here's Wanamaker. 14 points for him. Over Rose. Rebounded by Maker. Maker's got four rebounds in this game. 13 feet away. The shot is good off the backboard. Rose has got 4 points in the quarter.
Each possession, more confidence from Derrick Rose. He wants the basketball. He's starting to knock him down.
Got that bucket in no time at all. Here's Rose. He's got 22. Pass to Dumboya. Here's McCray. No good with the triple.
The defense got lucky there. That's one you expect him to drain.
Here's Williams. Offensive rebound. On the wing, Williams. No points in the game yet for him. Here's Mikhailuk. The shot, no good. Good work defensively by Smart. Puts one up from 19. That one's rebounded by McCray. Detroit's gone to the three-point shot 8 times already in the second half and hit 4 of them. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. The Pistons have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
Jordan McCray taking 2 shots.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he makes the first. And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
Here's Here's Wanamaker. Goes back up. And there's the bucket as Williams finishes it off. Williams has got his third bucket of the night.
Yeah, hard trying to keep Williams off the boards. He makes it a mission to keep possessions alive.
Picked his pocket. And up the court come the Celtics on the break. Here's Wanamaker, and it's Boston with another.
Just giving up way too many transition opportunities.
And it's Rose with the ball for the Detroit Pistons. There's the triple. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got 6 rebounds here tonight. Over Rose. And again, it's Boston converting.
You know, I know they want to make Williams a stretch 4 or 5, but the mid-range jumper at present is still where he's most comfortable.
Here's McCray. He has 5. Dumboya gets a wide-open look. The three-pointer is right on target. Dumboya's got 8.
And they have been relentless from deep. And you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
And now you can see the D having problems stopping the mid-range jumper, just not really closing out as much as they need to.
Here's McCray. Back to Rose. A 3-ball. Another 3 for Detroit.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those 3-point attempts.
Boston's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Here's Wanamaker. They get it again. Now here's Williams. He's covered closely. Pistons shooting 48% from the field as a team in this third quarter. And the dunk by Maker.
And he placed that pass out in front of him and let him just run into it in rhythm.
From the wing, that one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him. Wanamaker's got 10 points in just the second half. Outside Rose. From outside, off the mark.
Defensively, it's hard to account for everything. They gambled off him, and it worked.
From about 19 feet, and there are the Celtics with another basket.
Wow, 10 straight points from mid-range.
Here's McCray, guarded by Smart, and the shot no good from McCray. Boston's gone 3 of 3 from three-point land here tonight. Tatum, that's for 2. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls. Tatum's got 23.
Another good play. This is how they built the lead, calling on the right guys at the right time.
The reason why they've stayed aggressive, and they have not let up this entire night. And at this point, I wouldn't expect them to.
Now here's Williams. Sekou Doumbouya, unable to get his last shot to go. Fast break, here they come. Here's Mikhailiuk, and he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
Love the recognition, realizes that one is all him.
Sometimes that's the call. You want to be unselfish, but even more so, you want to be effective. Decent look from mid-range, but there may have been a better option for them in that set.
Great D that time from Tatum. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. And so it's Boston, enjoying the kind of gigantic lead you almost never see. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. Back right after this. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
Yeah, it's one thing to find the guy. It's another to deliver the ball where he can do something with it. Wonderful play.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. And on the floor for Detroit here in the fourth, we've got Derrick Rose. Dumboya is out there with Maker. Then there's McRae. And it's Musa in at the small forward position. Good on the triple.
Woo! He got a clean look, and he makes the defense pay for disrespecting him.
A steal. And oh, here we go. Rose, nobody back. And Rose throws it down.
Derrick Rose in open space is a treat to watch. Love the way he took off and scored that one.
And the turnover again by Boston. Green, he's checked in for Tatum. Here's Rose. Greg, it's pretty typical for players of the past to talk about current players and say, they may have struggled had they played when I played. What do you think of that line of thinking?
You know, I just don't agree with that. And I think we all do that. We all feel like our era was the best. I had the same thoughts being passed my way when I first came into the league.
I'm sure.
The reality is these guys work just as hard as guys worked back in our era. They just have more understanding of what their value is. And in a lot of ways, they've got more courage to speak out because, you know, let's face it, they're more of a bullseye on their back in today's era with social media than we've ever seen before.
That is true. That's good from Dumboya. And Walker's got the ball here for the Boston Celtics. Swiped it away to the paint. And the jam by Dumboya.
He takes advantage of them in every way possible.
And Greg, he lures them into a trap on the steal, and then bang, straight to the bucket.
Great activity at both ends. Great teamwork as well.
Green, it's good on the putback.
You know we talk about it all the time, guys. Those second chance buckets, always the result of that extra effort.
Here's Magruder. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. Maker passes to Musa. Six to shoot. Shoots it. Rebounded by the Celtics. Williams has got six rebounds now in the game. Fires it up. And it's off the back rim. No good.
Trying to finish out the game strong, you have to recognize who has the hot hand and get him the ball.
The pass to Musa. Shoots a fader. Yep, it counts. Musa's got his first 2 points.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Here's Langford, and Maker sends it back.
Watching him protect the rim, you never guess Maker's averaging less than one block a game for his career.
And the jam by Dumboya.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. And Green gets it to go.
Great timing. That can be the difference between an assist and a turnover.
Magruder kicks to Dumboya. Here's Musa. They grab their own miss, and the dunk by Maker.
Doing his job on the glass and doing it with force.
And Greg, it's not everybody in the league who can make those kinds of plays.
You know, this is one of his specialties, keeping plays alive, creating second chance opportunities.
So it's the Pistons now. After Romeo Langford's miss, Magruder passes to Dumboya. Misses the three. Boston's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. Here's Langford. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Langford's got his first points of the night. And the Pistons with possession. They're on a 16-6 run. Magruder passes to Musa. No good on the three.
They keep calling his number, which is partly how they've dug this hole.
Here's Cantor. That shot, no good. And Detroit the other way now. Here's Magruder. And the layup's good off the glass.
Not just selling for something along the perimeter. Excellent job.
Here's Green. Rebounded by Maker. Maker's got 8 rebounds in this game. Here's Musa. Offline with his 3.
I don't know how many shots he's missed this quarter, but they're going to have to find offense from someone else.
Great in transition. Langford makes himself available, and boy, he knows how to finish.
Pass to McCray.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Greg, last season was kind of a rough one, very turbulent for the NBA, the China controversy, the passing of David Stern, Kobe Bryant, and finally the COVID pandemic. Other than that, it was kind of uneventful.
Yeah, an incredibly tough year.
Wow.
You know, you just go back to March, and who would have ever thought we would go through what we went through? And you talked about all the other issues, David Stern and Kobe both passing. You know, I'm just hopeful we get a return to normality, because that sounds pretty good right about now.
It sure does. The Celtics making a switch here. Ogilvy is checked in. Boston's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. Walker goes in, and Maker sends it back.
And you know, Cantor can dominate on the court, but his real passion may be pro wrestling. He even held a pro title belt for a little while. He's a big, strong fella. I know I wouldn't want to be in the ring with him.
We'll be at the line shooting 2.
That's good from Cantor. Well, we know the NBA is looking to get rid of the one-and-done rule pretty soon. Adam Silver, Greg, saying he thinks the league can create a better system. Do you think so?
I think they can create a better system for some. I think the growth of the G League, no doubt, is instrumental in that new system. Now these young rookies can get the playing time in lower-tier pro games as they continue to develop. But I think still the collegiate game plays a significant role. The experience of going to college, even for a year, can be invaluable.
There are pros both ways, college or the G League. Agreed?
I do. I'm just glad it's not a one-size-fits-all proposition. Now you have the option. Not every kid wants to go to college and have that experience.
Yeah, how about the body control on that one? Narrowly misses getting the deuce.
Kemba Walker will be at the line shooting 2.
That free throw good from Walker. Kemba Walker hits them both. And last season, we saw the NBA All-Star Game introduce the Elam ending, a target score, Greg, to end the game. And instead of running out the clock, did you like that? And would you widen its use?
No question, it's being looked at maybe for overtimes or tournament games. You know, Adam not shy about exploring new ideas. And I got to be honest, going into the All-Star game, I wasn't a fan of the proposed changes.
Me too.
But once you saw it all play out, I have to say I was entertained. And I applaud the commissioner and the players in the league for buying in. And I think the fan experience was made all the more better.
Good point. Drills it from outside.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
They double-team Walker. Shot is good off the back rim and in. Walker's got 31.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
They double him with Langford. Passes it to Maker. Fires for three. The offensive rebound.
And the way they have controlled the glass this game, really impressive.
You know, you look at how they built this lead. It's been through extra possessions.
Mm-hmm. Now a timeout called by Boston.
And coaches looking to seize every advantage, maximize every possession.
Critical part of the game. You have to be flexible. You have to be able to adjust what you're doing.
Boston's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. Now, here's Langford. Puts it up from 17. Dumbuya pulls it in. Dumbuya's got rebound number 5 here tonight.
It's amazing. All night, he's been out of sync on the offensive end, yet they continue to lead.
Pulls up on the wing. And here's Kanter. It's in and good for his 6th field goal in 10 attempts. Pistons shooting at 52% from the field. They're clicking. Pass to Musa. Lays it up and banks it in.
That's the pass you want. Orchestrating the offense, creating for others.
Here's Langford. Kept alive by Boston. Ball stolen. 4-on-3 break with the shot. That one a little long. Well, the Celtics shooting only 35% in the fourth quarter. The offense looking a little rickety. Now the pass to Ojala. And it's blocked. Here's Magruder. Pass to McRae. Here's Musa. Dumbuya with it. Outside, Green. Tries again. And Maker sends it back. Pass break. Here we go. On up the court. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
And they've had assists now in their last 3 baskets.
Shot from the wing. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Langford's got 6 points in the quarter.
I like watching Langford when he's knocking down and trusting that jumper, proving he has the touch needed to do damage from outside.
Sinks the three-pointer.
Yeah, coming down the stretch, they've become reliant upon their perimeter game.
You know, when you're raining threes, you can stack up points in a hurry, but it can go the other way as well.
And it's good, 2 points.
And usually amongst the leaders, in their offensive rebound rate, Kanter gives your team found points off misses.
Here's Magruder. To the middle. Here's Maker. And the dunk by Maker.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Shot on the wing. And a little luck that time, but it drops. Walker's got 33 points.
I mean, what can you do? I mean, if Walker's going to make that, all you can do is tip your cap to him.
McRae, no good. Boston's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. Cantor, the pass to Ogilvy. 17-foot shot on the way. With the fadeaway. They get it back. Pistons shooting an outstanding 53% for the game. Here's McRae. It falls for his fifth field goal of the night. Now shooting 5-for-8.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring them back.
Walker. Here's Cantor. Yes, indeed, it is good. He's now 8-for-14.
And the coaching staff doesn't have any issue putting the ball in Cantor's hands inside. And why not? That part of his game is very refined.
And the dunk by Maker.
A lost art in this game. Terrific bounce pass.
And so Green will bring it up for Boston. Cantor trying to free himself up, and Green gets it to go.
And you see the ability to rise and fire from mid-range, even against that length.
And you know what? There was probably a better matchup on the floor, but when it goes in, nobody complains.
Now, here's Maker. Passes it to Musa. Lets it go from deep. Green with the rebound. Greg, the NBA under Adam Silver has been aggressive looking for ways to enhance the product and attract fans. Where do you fall on that point? Push the envelope or don't rock the boat, or maybe somewhere in between?
I think it might be somewhere in between. These days, people's attentions can be pulled in so many different directions. I think they're smart to not rest on their laurels and to continue to try to evolve. But with that evolution, sometimes it's not going to come over as well as they would like. But I'm a fan of some of the experiments, I should say, that we've tried thus far. And I hope the league continues to push the envelope.
That's a good thought. And it's Detroit's ball.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it, just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Celtics.
This was a very efficient offense tonight.
And they found a way to get their shots to go down. A little luck didn't hurt. A lot of their 50-50 shots fell their way.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Walker.
Ooh, he put on a clinic tonight. Terrific vision, sees the whole floor, and he hits guys in their spots with pinpoint dimes.
Here's Musa. Kemba Walker making his last shot. Basket,
timeout,
good.
Timeout.
And you gotta like that they found something positive here, something that maybe carry overs into the next game.
They put together some great possessions here at the end. It's a shame they could have used this run much earlier.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They lead by 35. 29 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, what do you think?
And the game pretty much over. Curious timeout here.
In my opinion, I think they're looking to make a substitution, but let's see out of the timeout.
Now, let's present our New Balance Player of the Game, Kemba Walker.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
The lift he got from this home crowd has been obvious. There's nothing fans love more than getting a big game out of someone other than one of their stars. ...29 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Cantor's shot is off. Here's McRae. 15 seconds left here in the fourth quarter.
And guys, you don't think this fella can do some major damage if he gets an opening to the rim.
GA, they just learned that lesson the hard way. They better put a little bit more effort into their D the next time down.
The defense has to feel real embarrassed right now. They totally got schooled on that highlight reel play.
And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
I know their fans appreciated it, and we saw at times just stretches of excellent defense, potency from an offensive standpoint as well. They were pretty much dominant.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.